Nice body shot, well picked.
Lovely shot.
He still looks hurt, doesn't he? I think Joe's going to jump all over him now. There you go.
I think it was cute. Joe did. He, you know, even though he's inexperienced, he picked the shot, the first shot, out lovely. But, you know, leaned his weight a bit, made the elbows rise, and then sunk a shot in. And then now he's just going in for the finish now. The second one was a lovely shot, but I think the first knockdown was well picked. He created the opening lovely.
I'm not sure Jake wants to be in there now, sort of.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, I think the ref done him a favour there. I don't think Jake wanted to be in there. I mean, we didn't learn a great deal with Joe. It's sort of what we expected, but he looks a great talent, and like you said, he's going to step out of his brother's shadow. He picked his shots well, didn't he? And like you say, that first shot was quite cute, how he set it up.
Yeah, I love the way he created the gap. You know, he sort of leaned his weight on, made the elbow rise, and then sank the left hook round the back of the elbow. The second shot was just letting his hands go, and then the last one, I think, as you said, Jake wanted out. I think he was going down a little bit easy at the last one. He was a rabbit in the headlights, so to speak. But I was really impressed with Joe, and I think they're the type of performances you've got to put in when you're in with a fighter, you know, with a record like he was in with tonight.
Yeah.
As I say, it does build pressure. So what you want to do is you want to go out and put a statement and, you know, try and beat him as good as anyone else has ever beat him. And I'm sure if you'd ask Jake, no one's probably done a job as good as that on him.
Well, we are here with Joe McGrail, and you know, you don't get paid for overtime in this business, but well, I mean, not many people do that to Jake Pollard. Great body shots there.
Yeah, happy with the performance. Been out for a few months, so. Happy, just happy getting back in there and getting the stoppage is obviously even better.
I just said to Paul there, there's some vicious kids in your gym there, and you proved it there. I mean, that was kind of like Mexican style, wasn't it?
Yeah, that's down to Paul and Anthony. That's the way we train every day. You know, we're throwing every shot is a spiteful and hateful shot. You know what I mean? That's just the way we train. So when we fight, it's just the same. You know what I mean? The fight is the easy part.
You know what I find interesting as well, each one of you guys at the Everton Red Triangle, you've all got your different styles as well. So it must be good there, you know, you're working and you're sparring with people with different styles as well.
Definitely, yeah, we've all got our own style. Paul works to our strengths, each and every one of us. So the spars in the gym, you're paid to see, you know what I mean, the top level spars. So it's all good in the gym at the moment, yeah.
There's a lot of people who are just watching that who are talking about you saying, well, this kid is someone to watch out for. I mean, just tell everyone why they should get on board with your journey right now.
Definitely, I'm just one of the many like up and coming fighters coming from the city. The city's flying, and I believe I'm up there with the top prospects along with everyone in our gym. So, yeah, everyone get behind us.
I might actually bring Paul. Can we bring in a sec? Got to bring Paul Stevenson in here because you know you guys are on an absolute roll at the minute. Everton Red Triangle, you're really making a statement.
Yeah, the lads are on fire, the gym's on fire, actually, you know, they're all bouncing off each other, we're on the rise, you know, it's good to see.
I know I've said this to you loads over the years, but each one of the fighters in your gym has a different style. We saw almost like a Mexican style tonight.
Yeah, yeah. It wasn't any vicious tonight, actually, with his body punching and clean air punching, and once Joe lets his hands go, you know, them fellas in the gym, they're feeling it as well, you know, so, yeah, they've all got different styles. Joe's his own person, Joe's a dark horse, and, you know, he's making his own name in the sport now, he's doing brilliant, we're made up with him.
What's it like working with Paul then? Because he's a bit of a taskmaster, isn't he? But he gets the best out of everyone.
Definitely, yeah. Paul's been my coach for since I started boxing when I was 7 years old, you know what I mean? So he's sort of like a father figure in a way. Not just in the boxing, but sort of in life as well, you know what I mean? If I ever need advice, obviously I go to my dad, but I can go to Paul as well, you know what I mean? I know he's there for stuff like that. And yeah, it's good having him there, and it'll always be that way.
Great bond in your gym, isn't there?
Yeah, there is actually a real family atmosphere, but all business, you know, when the bell goes, and you know, yeah.
A little update on the rest of the stable?
Yeah, next week, Andrew Kane defending his WBC international title. Brad Stand on the same card in 8 rounder, 2 good fights. Nick Boyle, just to be confirmed, fighting the beginning of May. And Peter McGrail out again soon as well. So all gyms buzzing. Big Bomber, Brown, be out soon as well. So yeah, all buzzing, all fighting, all active. Good.
one of the most vicious gyms in the country, I'm telling you right now. All right, it was great to speak to you, mate. You could have the final word. Do you want to say anything to people who are tuning in to watch?
Just thanks everyone who's watched on the, obviously on the YouTube, on the live stream, and thanks everyone who came. I sold a good few tickets, so I'm grateful for the support, and thanks to my coaches, Paul and Anthony. Thanks to all my sponsors, and thanks to my mum and dad, yeah.